We also study the conversion process
from one space to another. For example, if I have a square, so a square, I can decide to deform it.
That if you stretch this side, you will likely have something like this.
So you have deformed your square into a rectangle.
So sometimes also spaces can also deform into other, like tables, also and so on and so forth, like triangles.
Somebody will tell you that if you form this, this side, you end up with a what? It's going to be this. So a square has deformed to
a triangle.
And then down spaces. So sometimes you have this, so there is what you call local base. Local base and so on, some covering spaces, which maybe we'll study later. But we are going to look at first now, how to now imagine the separation. What happens when you have more than one space in the in a given structure? When you want to mold more than one space, maybe in this room you want to arrange maybe blocks. Blocks are rectangle. How do you arrange in a given space, for example? And what is the relationship between the boundary of one in respect of the other? So this is what we call separation spaces, and that's why you also see us talk about different spaces. But first, the fundamental thing to know is that these spaces are not empty spaces. They are actually built by elements. Every space is actually built from what? Elements. So you start with a T naught space. This is the smallest. What is T naught space? A topological space. Topological space X star is called T naught if whenever you pick two elements, X1, X2, in the topology, X, there exists an open set U. Okay, of course, subset of X4, such that X1 does not belong to you, but X2 belongs to this U. So that means, for example, if you have a bigger space than this, in this U X, you can always have a situation where you have two points, X1 and X2, inside X, such that you can build an open set U around X2. So U is an open set containing X2, but does not contain X1. So when you have space like this, you say you have a T0 space, okay? Yes. Example of spaces that are not T0 in the script. Example of topological spaces not T0, number one, indiscrete space. And you know the indiscrete space is this, oh? The topology was the purest element, oh? The X and this. This is not T0. Why? Because you have an X here, and you have nothing else, because empty cell has no element, isn't it? So all the elements here are actually domicile in X, so X1, X2, and there is nothing outside. What you have outside is an empty space. So you don't have the complement of having two elements in a layer. One inside, one outside. All the elements are inside. So this is not a T-mod. But you can think of some more examples like this. For example, maybe this your classes, you can say it's not T-mod.
Because if you are, but it is not when all of you are students inside and there's nobody who is not a UGPO student. You say all of you are UGPO and there is no, you say there is no outsider. But so long as I come here, I'm not a UGPO student, then we already have a team of people. Our two elements, one outside, I don't belong to this group. But if it's only you around, maybe you are doing some meeting, sometimes you say, let us call only the members. Or maybe you want to discuss something which you don't want somebody who is not a member to do. Then all the elements are inside. There is no body, there is no element. So this is not team. Okay. So long as somebody comes in who is not here, you have a team. Okay? You can think of more and more example like families now. In families, when you have structures of families, they are not team, because all of the people inside are members of the community. Isn't it? There is nobody inside who is not a member inside. So and so on and so forth. There are so many other examples of team. We go to the
T1's a topological space now is called a T1 space if whenever there is two elements x1, x2, and x, there exists two open sets. Maybe U and V, okay, two open sets U and V. Of course, here you will expect U to be a subset of tau. Is also, and they are all subsets of X, of course. Because one of them are also, U is contained in X, V is also contained in the set V as a topology. So, the set with a standard topology, such that X1 belongs to you, okay? But X1 does not belong to you. And X2 will belong to me, and X2 will not belong to you. Okay, so you have a sense of separation now. You separate two sets, each one, like you are constructing like neighborhoods.
Just like you are constructing, you have X1 here, so you construct a network about to call you. Then you have X2, because they can intersect, it doesn't matter. They can even want to intersect. This is so you can see clearly that this X1 is not in B. This X is also not in B. Okay. So you have a sense of two open sets now. So one and the T1.
Now you may wish to ask, is there a relationship between T1 and T0? Or are they different? Are they the same? Okay. You may have a sense of asking like this. What seems to be clear is that if you have a T0 space, it is automatically what? It is automatically T1. Oh, T0 are automatically T1, but T1s are not automatically T0. Okay? Yes. So, T0 will imply T1 because the same definition. See, there is S2 here. Look at me. There is S2 here, not me. There is S1 here. So, if you take U to be one element set, if you take U to be one element set, that means it's only X1 that is inside. This is T0, isn't it? Automatically, yes. But you may not say, you are not sure that T1 implies T0. Okay, you are not sure of that. It's not true that table T1 is a T matrix. Example, this shared pins, shared pins. Pins key space. Statistic space, I think, is is made of X and Y. But supposing my X is here, suppose X is this element. What are the subsets of X? What are the subsets of X? The subsets are what? A, B equal, A, and S. So if I now add empty set here and say this is my shared pin space. This space is what? This space is, of course, it's T1. Isn't it? Because you have two elements here, for example, A and B. You can build two A, B here. I can say, for example, this is my A, B. And this is mine. Oh, I don't want to say that they share the same element. Let me say this is my B, this is my A. Wrong already. One element here, one element outside. This does not belong here. This does. So I have no problem with that. But look at it coming. If we are to say this is X, this is already T0, of course, because we know we have these two elements on the side. But is it T1? Because my space X contains A, and there is not any other element, isn't it? There is not any other element outside A. Because the first one is A, the other inside A. So I don't have any element here to say this is what? Tino. Because Tino says you have to have a space, a set with more than one element, of course, since we are talking about a set now. And then you have to have a single element outside.
That is the requirement of T.
Now I have a space with more than one element because it's AB. But I don't have another element apart from this because it's empty. Isn't it? So this is not T. Does not imply T1. T1 does not imply T0. Being T1 does not imply that you promise to get T1. Good. What about the red line? You compare the red line, for example. If you want to build this space in the red line, sometimes you can do that. For example, you can say, if I say this is my A, this is my B, I can decide to define some radius around each one, some radius maybe R1. Now I have built, this is a space, a set, an open set containing B. This is an open set containing A. This is T1. Isn't it? This already you are a T1 spaces. So you can even use red line to construct your T1 space. And you can see clearly that in that case you can also build T not here because I may decide to just forget about it and pick an element only B. An element one point. And this is A. Then this becomes our T note. This becomes a T note. So you can use their line to look at these structures. But see, I think this space is actually low, which is because it contains, the X contains all the elements in the other one. So, these are space, also called house space. The topological space now is T2 or house block is T2 or house block if whenever x1, x2 belongs to x, the elements in the set topology that exists U and B also in S, okay, such that U intersection B is empty. That's the only additional requirement you need, and that is one. That can X in U implies X is not. X2 and B imply X2 is not. So you have the sense of two spaces now, U and B is X1 and is X2, but disjoint. Remember I told you in T1 the spaces are not necessarily disjoint. Okay? You have them like this, so long as you can have S2 here, because this is T1, they don't have to be disjoint, but the one element must not be beside the other. But this one, they have to be disjoint. So this is the only difference between the two spaces. What does this tell you? This tells you what? That if you have T2, you already have T1, isn't it?
So T2 automatically implies T1, T1. But T1 does not necessarily imply what? Oh? Because this fits in. This fits in as T1, but the compass is not true. Why? Because of this requirement. Because the things that must be. This is not, it is not necessary in T1, but it is always necessary in what? So that means you cannot always construct T2 using T1, because some T1s are like this. Now, if they are like this, they don't satisfy this requirement, so they cannot be T2. But when they are like the other time I told you, supposing I have this thing. This is my T1. It is also T2 by the pitch. Because they are disjoint. But what about if my intervals are like this? Maybe this is my center. X. So I say A1, B1. A2, B3. Not problem, because they have so much in common, isn't it? But you can still construct T1 because you can come here and pick an element. This does not belong here. So you have your T. But you cannot have T2 because none of them have something in common. This one will not hold here. Yeah. So you can't already say. So T2 space automatically implies T1. But the compass is not always.
I think what is clear is that most of these properties are so much related, so much that some of them can be used for structures, as you can see. Just like, for example, trying to expand from one space to another looks like something like this. That follows because you can always expand from smaller space to the bigger one, but naturally you don't expand from bigger to smaller. So they say you are shrinking if you do that. For example, you don't start education from university down, but you can start from primary school up. That's why sometimes smaller spaces can be used to construct bigger spaces. But you don't take a bigger space to construct a smaller space.
So, regular spaces. A topological space as it's down, it's called regular. If given two open spaces, U and P, together will exist. That exist an element X belonging to you. And a colossus, let me call it A. Okay, content. Okay. So you have the sense of two of them, you have an open set here. This is U, so you have an S concept. And you have another open set here, this is B, and you have a colossus, and A inside. So I'm not talking of elements now. An element and the process. okay, then when you have that, you say your space is regular. For example, if you are constructing an estate, and you make it a duty that every household, every housing unit in that estate will have two structures. A house, a great house, and maybe a tree in front of that house. We have a tree here outside, you cannot have a tree inside. So each house you plant one tree. You have the house, that's a closet, and outside it you have a single element, a tree. Another house, a tree. This is regular, you say then your space is regular. But if you have a, in that case, your topology is the estate map, estate. That means every house you find, there will be a tree. If whenever you have this happens, then you have a regular space. You say your essence is regular, like uniform. But if there are some houses out trees, then you say this essence is not uniform, so it's not regular. Because some houses have, some other houses do not. But if whenever you think you will have this happen, then you say the space is regular. Good. It follows therefore that regular space is automatically T1. Yes. But they are also automatically T2 because we have two spaces. You can take an element here. This is such. That's one. But they cannot be T0 because that's an element outside.
A is a closed set in X, and X does not belong to A. There is a continuous function from S to I, with I from 0 to 1, such that F of X is 0, and F of X is, F of Y is 1. So, so I will read a topological space X tau, topological space X tau is completely irregular if and only if now, and only if, so it's a strong condition here. If I'm only if whenever A is a closed set containing X, a closed set, and you have a point X in X, and
so that you already have a definition of regular. You have a closed set. Let me complete this. There exists U and V such that X is U and A is contained in models. So you have the definition of regular now. And together with, let me say together, the function, okay, F from S to I, where I is defined as a closed interval of 0, 1. Okay, so we have two elements.
So, such that f of x 0 and f of y is 1 for some y and a.
Okay. You pick an element in the closet and f of y is 1. So when you have this, so it's like you have a sense of function which runs from 0 to 1, which now defines elements of x. Whenever you pick an element, of course all the elements are in x, but whenever an element also belongs to
remember x belongs to what? Did I say x belongs to you? Did I say somewhere? Okay, I didn't. So why is x is actually in you?
Okay, you have the two sets, it's you. Whenever you have an element, remember you has more than one element. So all the maybe x1, x2, x3, x3. So for all these x's, f of x 1 is equal to f of x 2 equals and so on, and they are all 0. Isn't it? Right here in the closet you have y1, another point here y2, another point here y3. F of y1 is equal to f of y2 is equal to, and they are all 1. Isn't it? Then when you have a situation like this, you say you are set, your space is completely variable. It is completely regular. Yes, so completely regular spaces are automatically regular, isn't it? Once you are completely regular, you are automatically regular. But the converse is also not always in topological space, X star is called normal. It's called normal if it's normal. If, okay. Whenever you have two open sets that exist, not means that exist, open sets U and B such that, and that is, and 2 closets A and B, because they are all subsets of X. Divine, you will also know that because you and we are also subset of what? Because this is a bigger space. Such that you have this diagram here. You have A between U. You have some B. So when you have this, you say you have a regular space. Two closets. One is inside you, an open set U. The other one is inside an open set U. You have this one, you say it's normal. Normal space. So you can see if you are regular, you are also normal, isn't it? Yes. Also normal, because you have additional requirement that you have even to cross it instead of just a point here. Say that because for normal you require additional property that f of x is 0, which you are not sure will hold here. Yes. But completely normal, regular normal spaces
we now attach additional property to this. Like
the number T1 space is called a T4.
There's another name we call this one, we call it T4. No. But we are not sure
yeah.
These are bots. So we have not defined any function on A and B. But we used to define function on the process and your point and your opens. Now we have to process. So we call this a T4 space.
A subspace E1 is compact, it is closed and bounded. This is one of the simplest definitions of compactness in honor of N. Borel and Labas. They also have this notion. Once you have a subspace which is closed and which is also bounded, then you say which is compact. So a subspace is subspace maybe E or R, whatever it is. Sometimes you call it E with some topology in it. Okay, is compact whenever closed and is also bounded. You have two requirements now. It has to be closed, that means it has to contain its endpoints or the inherent points. And second requirement is that it is bounded. It is both bounded below and bounded what? Then when you have a space like that, it's compact. What is the difference between that the space can be closed but may not be bounded? Do you agree?
Well, I say which is closed but not bounded. I think let us consider an open space. An open space. If you look at it, you'll see skies. It looks like it is closed. But you don't have bounds. That if you keep going, you may not reach the primary. Isn't it? Whatever a singleton set, one element set, X, can be closed. Now it's both closed and open. But is it bounded? There's no lower bound, no upper bound, because it's not an interval. Is it? So, but when you have the two, both closed, and bounded. Bounded means it has an intimum and supremum. Is it? Then you say it is a compact. This is the definition of Lebas. This is the same definition of Borel. Well, we have another definition. What is open and closed for? Because some say that, some other definition says that space is closed, it has a closed power. Okay? So what is an open cover? What is a closed cover? Take a topological space, then the collection of open subset T alphas in the discrete space is called a cover of the topology. So let me define this open cover. Is there a topology? S tower, for example, then you know in the topology you have collections of G alphas. Now consider collection of G alphas, each one such that G alpha I is actually containing X for any I. Then you call this M, ratio of all G alphas, where alpha is some indexing set. Okay. You discover that this is a collection of covers upon sets, upon subsets. M by each one is a upon subset. And each G alpha, of course, is in type of upon subset. What do you call this? You call it an open cover. Okay? This is called a cover under a cover for so that's okay. Of course, it's for the space, it covers the space based on the topology. But each G alpha is also in tau, so it covers the whole topology better. It's like if you have this as a topology, this class, and I may take this one to be G alpha 1, G alpha 2, G alpha 3, G alpha 4. By the time I take the union of all the G alphas over I, I'm going to recover my S. That's the whole space, isn't it? Or you are talking of Jesus University. You say as a student of maths, or as a student of chemistry, or as a student of education, you will now form a cover. That means they actually form the population of the universe. Then a part of closed cover. A subcover of topological space such that U beta, beta and gamma, another cover of S tau, a subcover, sorry, not close cover, a subcover. Now you can define another subcover. Sub cover. This is a cover and the other is sub cover. Now, you know you have M, which we say is a collection of G alphas, open an indexing set. We say this will cover, this is a cover, is a cover for, we say, X. Now define another, define N now. Set of B, B alpha or B I, for I, and that's it. Such that every beta I is a cover for some G alpha. Is it clear? Then, in that case, N will be called a sub. Each beta I is going to be a subcover, some cover for some G alpha. So, math, for example, G alpha 1, if you get G alpha 1, you can say is beta 1 union beta 2 up to maybe beta. And this one is a cover for this. This is a cover for X. So, this is a cover. This is a soft cover, just like you have bases and soft bases of topology. So, good.
So, beta n or m, where n is some finite number, then you say topology is a But if open covers or covers of the topology do not have finite sub-covers, then your topology is not compact. Is it clear? It is not compact. I'll give you an example. If you say in Nigeria, each state, each border, in each border is maybe secured. You know how many, you know, the number of villages you have at the border, and you have actually secured them, maybe you have fenced them, and you go to border B, you can also have a finite fence, you know, you can cover it. Border C is when you can say the whole of the country is compact. But if you have some places where you cannot know the, you cannot actually cover, you cannot fence, because it has to be closed and bounded. For example, if you are bordering sea, it's very unlikely that you'll be able to have a what? To not to have a actually a fence there, you cannot come there. Or you cannot, sometimes you cannot even secure it. But if that is the case, you don't have finite sub-covers. In some places you can fence, but in some other places you cannot fence. So you say the whole space is now, is what? It's not compact. But in this, in what of in this university, if you can secure the eastern part, the western part, the other, this part is not secure. This one is secure. Then you can say this surrounding is not. Of course, it's close, but not all of it has a finite subcover. Yes. If you are considering the whole now to be your bound, so it has to be closed and bounded. It may be closed because you know where the boundary is, but it's not bounded. There's no wall saying that this is where it is. So it's not compact. So that's the definition, alternative definition, which is very similar to the one we have seen by Levax and Borel. And lastly, I think I will define connectedness. Connected. A topological space is connected. We say this is connected if number one, S is not equal to G1 union wire G1 and G2 belongs to tau, but minus the empties. They are not empty. And G1 intersection G2 is actually okay. Then you say this is connected. Okay? Then you say the topology, this topological space, you can now, if you can break the whole of it into just two sets, the whole space, for example, if I can break this class into just two subsets, G1, G2, such that none of them is empty. G1 is not empty, G2 is not empty. But if I take the intersection G1 intersection, I will get an empty. And then I will say my topology is what? Connected. Connected. Meaning that they don't share anything in common. This looks like what you need. Used to be called partitions. This is G1, this is what? And partitions, they are like this. G1 intersection G2 is actually empty.
but U and G2 are not empty. One to a topology space is like this, then you say it is what? Otherwise, you say your topology is disconnected. It's over or it's not connected. That means if one of these is empty, then you say it is not connected. Because the other one, then the other one is, you now say G1 and G2 are empty. What if G1 is empty? No, of course G1 and G2 will be empty. So G1 is already an empty set. But then you are left with only what? What? Because G1 being empty, there is nothing here. So the whole space is just one. So there is no, nothing like connection here. Nothing is connected to anything. Yes, but if you don't require this, then you always have it. And say this is connected to that. Yes, so I think we have this, with these questions we can now assume that you have about the topologies, the structures, the properties, which you can actually read on and read more. Okay? So the next time you will be taking some toilets.